Good morning. Today we will discuss about loops. Let's start with while loop today. Loop is basically used when we have to execute a group of statements or a block statement several times. C program supports three types of loops. One is while loop, second one is do while, and third one is for loop. Today we will have a look at while loop. It's while loop can be written in this format: while in parenthesis test condition, and within curly braces we can write the statements, either one or more than one statement. This may be referred as body of the loop. Initially the condition is tested. If the condition is true, and the body will be executed, and the statements written inside the body of the loop are executed one by one. Once the body is executed, again the condition is tested, and the process will continue to execute the body of the loop unless the condition is false. Let's have a look with the help of a flowchart. Firstly, condition is tested. If the condition is true, body of the loop is executed, and once all the statements are executed, it will return back to the test condition. Again, it will verify the test condition. If the condition is true, it will continue to execute the loop, and the process will continue until the statement becomes false. Once the statement is false in the test condition, you are taken out of the loop. The next statement after the loop is executed. Let's take an example. We have declared a variable I of integer type with value 0, and within while loop we are using test condition I is less than 2. And body of the loop contains two statements. First statement is printf welcome to loop, and second statement is I++. Plus is an increment operator. It increases the value of I by 1. Now let's take an example and see how the loop is working. Initially, I is initialized with value 0. In the next statement, I is tested whether I is less than 2. In this case, the value of I is 0, so condition is true. So we will enter the loop, and it will display print welcome to loop. In the next statement, value of I is increased by 1. That is, initially the value of I is 0. Now, after incrementing, it becomes 1. Once it is over, we will return back to the test condition. Now again we will verify the test expression. Here a value of I is 1, and 1 is less than so 2, so the condition is still true. So again you will enter the loop, and again it will display welcome to loop. Now I is incremented by 1, and it becomes 2 now. Again we will test the condition. I value of I is 2, and 2 is not less than 2, so the condition is false. You will be taken outside the loop. This is how a loop works. Let's take a program and execute it to check the output. We have declared a variable I and initialize it with value 0. Now write while loop. While test condition I is less than 2. In curly braces, write printf. Printf is a statement used to display information on a screen. Welcome to loop. Put a semicolon. Now increment the value of I by writing I++. Let's execute the program and check the output. We are compiling the program. You can see welcome to loop is displayed twice. Now use slash n to display the masses in two separate lines. Slash n, we are putting slash n here. Now again execute the program, compile and run the program. Now this time you will find welcome to loop in two separate lines. Now investigate how we are getting the output twice. Initially the value of I is 0. Condition is tested here, 0 is less than 2, condition is true. So you will enter the loop. It will display slash n welcome to loop. On the screen you will get welcome to loop. Now value of I is increased by 1. So now I becomes 1. Again we will return back and now check whether 1 is less than 2 or not. In this case the condition is still true. So you will again enter the loop and slash n, it will take your cursor to the next line and display on the screen welcome to loop is displayed again. Now increase the value of I by 1. So I becomes 2 now. Now condition is tested, 2 is less than 2. No, the condition is false. So you are now outside the loop. And you will encounter getch. You must be knowing that getch is basically used to accept input of one character. So when you will press any key, the program will terminate. You will return back to the program. Now see if the value of I is not increased, what will happen? In this case, I will remain constant at 0. So the condition will remain true always. It will never increase. So in this case, you will encounter infinite loop. So the masses welcome to loop will be displayed several times. And it will continue display on the screen. This is an infinite loop. What if we decrease the value of I instead of increasing it? In this case as well, as the value of I will decrease from 0 to minus 1, minus 2 and so on, so I will never reach 2.2. so I is less than 2 will always remain true. In this case also you will find infinite loop. In this case as well, you can see welcome to loop is displayed n number of times, infinite times. It will continue in this fashion. What if we increase the value of I by 2? For that you can write I plus equal to 2. This will increase the value of I by 2. Now execute the program and check what is happening here. You will find that welcome to loop is displayed once only. Let's check how it is happening. Initially value of I is 0. And condition is tested here, 0 is less than 2, condition is true. It will display welcome to loop and then increase the value of I by 2. So I becomes 2 now. 0 plus 2 is 2. So now again it is tested whether 2 is less than 2. No, it's false. So you are taken outside the loop. So in this way it will display welcome to loop only once. What will happen if the condition is not true even once? Say I have taken I is equal to 3 and here I is less than 2 is the test condition. In this case 3 is less than 2, the condition is false. So in this case it will not enter the loop, it will directly encounter getch. Let's check it out. It is not showing anything. So when the condition is false, while loop is not executed. That's all for now. In the next video,